So guys, I hope you all are doing well. So in this video, we'll be discussing about Cognizant Automata Fixed Questions and Answers 2021. So we'll be discussing about why it is there in Cognizant written test and what is the significance. And we'll be discussing about the frequently asked Cognizant Automata questions and the answers. So I am requesting all of you to watch this video till the end if you want to crack this section or the automata section. So before discussing further, if you are new to our channel, then please subscribe and press the bell icon for more job updates or the lateral hiring updates and the interview preparation videos or the interview preparation guides. So recently here you can see we have uploaded regarding latest off campus. So please watch our recent videos especially and apply for the job roles as per your eligibility and the as per your areas of interest by simply clicking on the links that were provided in the description of each video. So now let's discuss about our topic first. So first of all, we'll be discussing about what is the Cognizant Automata Fixed Question about this section. So it is a new section being added by Cognizant in its written test or the recruitment drive pattern. So you can code in any your desired language like C or C++, Java, Python, etc. So this section test that how good you are in fixing a code written by someone else, or if you can add a small function of your own in someone other's code by without changing the output of the code. So for example, suppose you are being shortlisted for an IT company. So in an IT company, whenever you are working in a project with other team members, so minimum of 5 to 6 team members or 2 3 team members will be there in your team. So whenever you are working with a team member, either the team member will be inside your company with us in the same location, otherwise he or she will be in a different location or the remotely he will be working with you in a team. So whenever suppose he or she is typing some code of 500 to 600 lines of code and then sending you via email. So after that, you need to check all these things, what is the functionality, what is the code. Then you must be having that capability or knowledge that you will be able to understand what is the functionality or how it is working, etc. So whenever you are launching that product or software, suppose a customer is reporting some issue or facing any functionality issue, etc. And reporting that thing, you need to clear that out by understanding the bug or etc. or the reports. So that's why they have added this section in their written test. So it checks your ability, whether you are able to fix the code written by someone else or like solving the bugs, etc. So now let's discuss about the pattern. So in this pattern or in this section, there will be 7 automatic questions and duration will be getting only 20 minutes to solve 7 questions. That means hardly will be getting 3 minutes for each question, and difficulty level is high. It is not medium or easy, but the candidates, those who have done some practice before attending this drive, they will find it medium. Difficulty level will be medium for them, because these questions are very easy. Logically, there will be some slight different things will be little bit different or tricky, but not, it is like rocket science question. They will not be asking. There will be small logical changes or the logical errors will be there. You need to find that. No worries. We'll be discussing about minimum of 10 to 15 questions in this video, and you will be able to solve at least 70 to 80% of the questions. If you are practicing very well, you'll be able to solve the 90 to 95 questions in this section. So now let's discuss about the pattern. So type of questions, there will be basically 3 types of question. So first one is the logical. So there may be some logical errors in the code which candidate must be able to find and resolve. So like bugs, or you can say the syntactical error, etc. Then compilation, there may be some compilation error in the code. The candidate must be able to find the syntactical error and resolve them. Then third one is the, or the third type or the third pattern is the code reusability. So the candidate must try to reduce the length of the code without changing the functionality of the code. That means the output must be same. You need to change the code or the length of the code. So this it checks whether you know the code reusability knowledge you have, if you have that skill or not. So they checks. So these are the three different patterns, or you can say types of questions asked in the Cognizant Automata fix round, or you can say section. So now let's move to the some of the frequently asked questions and the answers. So the first question is the find the syntax error in the below code without modifying the logic. So this is the question. Here you can see. So in this section, or for the first question, here you can see I have mentioned, or I have given some hint in which line the error is. So in the next one to five questions, there will be some hints. So after 5 to 6 questions, there will be no hints. So you have to find the errors by yourself. So first of all, we are mentioning all these things because you'll be having a little bit comfortness to solve all these questions, or you'll be getting some hint in which line the error is. So now let's understand. So let me use my pencil. Yeah, so has include, so it's a C programming or C code question. So integer main, the main function is there, float x equal to 1.3. So we have initialized x equal to 1.3. We are using the switch case. Then case 1, printf, the choice is 1.3. We are simply printing the output. Then break default, print invalid choice. For the default, then break, return 0. So we have already given you the hint. In this line, there is an error. So you can pause this video and try to solve by yourself. What is the error? Why we are getting this error, this kind of error? You can try to solve this question by yourself by simply pausing this video. Try to think. Take 5 to 6 seconds only you'll be getting, because totally you'll be getting approximately 3 minutes to solve all this question. So this is an easy question we have provided, because first from easy to difficult will be moving. So here you can see, if you see carefully, if a normal person or a normal candidate, or the candidate those having less coding skills, if they see this, they will be thinking, yeah, it's a switch case we have used, case 1, case 2, and a default case is there, we are returning 0. It's fine. But the candidate those who have good programming skill or the coding skill, they will definitely able to find the error, or will be able to spot the error within fraction of seconds, or within 10 seconds, maximum 10 seconds they will be taking, because in the line 4 the error is. So if you see carefully, we have used 1.3. what happens in the switch case? So we have inserted, or you can say we have provided the value of x inside the switch case. So what will happen, it will move from case 1 to case 2 like this, 1, then it will move 2, then 3, 4, up to x it will move. So here first of all it will check x case equal to case 1 equal to the choice is 1.3. it will simply print, then it will be moving to 3. But here we have initialized x equal to 1.3, the fractional number is there, so we can't move like this, because between, if you have gone through this or not I don't know, within 1 to 2 there are infinite numbers are there. In the mathematics, during your school, you might have read that between 1 to 2, there infinite numbers are there. So if you run the switch case, definitely you will be getting an error. So you can't use this. So now let's move to the explanation for a better understanding. So either we can use 1.3 or we can use 1 or 2 or 3, any integer number. The floating number must not be there. So here you can see, if you write 1 or 2, the switch case will definitely print something. So if you read the explanation, the expression used in the switch case must be integer type or character type or enum. Any other type expression is not allowed here. That means floating, double are not eligible, or you can say are not applicable inside a switch statement or switch case. So this is all about the first question. It's a very easy question. For the first time you are watching this video, or this is the beginning of this video, so that's why I have added this easy or the medium difficulty level question. So later we'll be discussing some of the tricky questions. So please watch this video till the end. So the next question is find the logical error in the below code again. So here again we have provided you some of the hints here. So totally there are two errors are here. So please try to solve by yourself. Just a second. Let me remove the errors. Okay. So now let's move to the second question. So here, integer I, j, n equal to 5, for I equal to n, I equal to 1, I less than equal to n. So if you see carefully, first error is the in this line. So if you want to rectify the error, or the if you want to spot the error by yourself, you can pause this video, no issues. So now let me explain. So here, semicolon is there, first error, semicolon must not be there. And if you see here, so we are going to print I, then again you need to print the next line, slash n, that means that we want to print the next line. Here, if you see carefully, we want to slash n equal to, we want to print something in the next line, but here forward slash is there. But forward slash must not be there. Backward slash should be there if you want to print something in C. So this is the second error, and the first error is the semicolon must not be there. We should erase the semicolon. If you erase these two things or rectify these two things, then definitely we will be getting some output. So this is all about the error. Again, it's a easy, or you can say average difficulty level question. This type of questions you will be getting. If you have a little bit practice on these things, you will definitely able to crack this section, because they will not be asking you rocket science question, because you will be getting 2.5 minute to 3 minute. So it very difficult to rectify a hard difficulty level question. So this is a medium difficulty level question, but the students or the candidates, those who have less practice in these things, they will definitely find this section as hard. So now let's move to the third question. Find the logical error in the below code again. So if you see here, again we have given you some hint. Again, you can pause this video and try to solve by yourself. So you can see we have started this main function. So integer a, b, and a equal to b equal to 4. Both a and b value are 4. B equal to a plus plus. So we are printing d a plus plus b minus bb. So we are going to print this. So where is the error? So if you see carefully, we have done some mistake here. What is that? So let's move to the explanation, so that I'll be able to make you understand more in a better way. So if you see here carefully, so inside the scanf we take percentile ampersand d, but while printing something you need to type or write percentage d. This is a simple error here, but most of the candidates ignore this, because they might be thinking, or sometimes we do the silly mistakes. So that's why they ask you the silly questions or the silly mistakes questions. So that's why you will get confused whether it is right or wrong, because they will not be giving you a compiler. Otherwise you might must have simply copied the things, all these things, and simply paste and run and check where is the error coming or you are getting. You will not be getting any compiler, so that time you will get confused. If you don't have any more practice, you will definitely get confused. So let's move to the fourth question. Check for the syntax or the logical error and correct the error to get the desired output. So n they have given, you need to print 0 to n, even or odd numbers, by identifying whether the n or the given number is even or odd. So suppose we are taking n equal to 10, the output should be 0 2 4 6 8 and 10, because we have taken 10 equal to even number. So that's why it will only be printing the even numbers as given in the question. For example, we are taking the second input as 9, the output would be 1 3 5 7 and 9. So up to 9 or up to that number we need to print from starting from 0 to n. So here is the code. Again, we have given you some hints here, so please try to solve by yourself later, otherwise I'll be explaining it to you. So if you see carefully, we have initialized first I n and print n. We are asking for the user input here. Then we are taking the number here, scanf. While taking the scanf, or you can say while taking the input, star must not be there, first error. Then second error is n reminder, or the n you can say divided by 2 equal to 0. So we are assigning something, or you can say you are checking something. So at that moment, the double equal to must be there. So whenever assigning something, the single equal to will be there. But while we are checking something, you must 2 equal to must be there. So then for loop is there. So if you see carefully, semicolon is missing. Third error. Then we are printing this one. One means 0 to n we are printing, or else we are checking. Otherwise, here if you see carefully, we forgot one thing. I less than equal to n must be, because we are simply here, we are printing. Here we are printing 0 to n. As per the question, you must be printing 0 to n. So here if you see carefully, here we are only printing I less than n. Suppose we are taking 10, it will simply print up to 9. That means it will be simply printing 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Because it's an even number and 9 is odd, it will simply printing up to 8. But we want to print up to n. So in this line also the same issue or the same mistake. Here equal to sign must be there. So this is all about that. Totally there are 4 errors are there, and we need to rectify this if you want to print the output or the correct output. So this is all about this. So this is the correct answer here. So you can check here, equal to must be there, double equal to must be there, ampersand n. So this is all about the fourth question, and let's move to the fifth question. Check whether the below program prints the below pattern or not. So this is the pattern. Suppose the user is entering 5, then the pattern should be like this, 1 to 5 and 5 to 1. So if you see carefully here, there are two patterns are there. So the first pattern is the upper triangle and the second pattern is the lower triangle. So totally there are two patterns we need to print. First this pattern and then the second pattern. So if you, I don't know whether you are aware about the pattern problem or the pattern programming, then you'll be able to solve this. So simply you need to do the partition of this question, or you can divide this pattern into two parts, so that you will be able to solve this. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4 and 5, 5, 5. Then again the lower triangle you need to print. So now let's understand how to do this. So this is the answer. You can see we need to find whether where is the error, and we need to rectify it. So if you see carefully, everything is fine. Here we are taking n, to the total number of rows. This is the row and this is the column. Column wise you need to print. For the first row you need to print first one. So for the first row, the I equal to 1 and n equal to 1, I equal to 1 and j equal to 1, row and column. For the second one, second row, column, first column we need to print 2, and for the second column we need to print 2. For the third row, we need to first print, in the first column we need to print 3, then in the second column we need to print 3, and in the third column we need to print 3. So like this we'll be printing up to 5. So here if you see carefully, everything is good. Already we have given you the hint. Directly you can move up to this point, because we are not fully explaining, otherwise it will be taking 1 hour to explain all these things. So you'll get bored, and I don't have any more explaining experience here or teaching experience before, so I'll get also bored. So here you can see for loop everything is fine. So we are printing I less than equal to n, means up to n we are printing. Then again for loop I j equal to 1, up to I we are printing. It's fine, we are taking first loop, or you can say first condition. This is for the upper half triangle. For the next triangle, we need to print this. But if you see carefully, we are going to print the lower half triangle. Means first of all, it will be printing 555. That means in the reverse way, we need to go. This was the easiest way. In the reverse way, we need to go. So if you see carefully here, first of all, j equal to 1 and I less than equal to I. It's true, but j equal to 1 and j less than equal to 1, it should not be there. It should be incremented. That means I less than equal to j less than equal to I. That means 1 less than equal to 5. So like this, we'll be printing up to j equal to j plus 1. It should be there. It is not j minus 1. So if we're correcting this, we'll be getting the correct output. So if you see carefully here, j equal to j plus 1. This is a easy question, or you can say a little bit tricky, not easy, because people might be thinking, yeah, it's fine, or it's a lengthy question. You can skip this, simply we write anything and try to solve this. So this is a easy question, but a little bit confusing. So now let's move to the second question. So the next question is the check the syntax or logic error and correct the code for the desired output. In this code, you need to find the greater among the three numbers or the three digits. So everything is good. Here you can see we are taking the user input, enter the three numbers, first number, second number and third number, then we are checking the maximum. So if you see carefully, there is an error in this line. So A greater than B, question mark. So we are checking, but here the semicolon must be there, because it's a, you can say, the either or concept. So it's an easy concept. Instead of question mark, there should be a semicolon. That's it. Other things are correct except this part. So you need to replace semicolon, and you must have be changing. After that, you will be able to get the correct output. So here an explanation, no need to follow any explanation. It's an easy question. So now let's move to the seventh question. So write a program in C to display the table of the number and print the sum of the multiples in it. So it's an easy question again. So you are required to write the code must be logically or syntactically correct. So for example, we are taking the input is 5. The output should be 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, up to 50. And the sum of these things would be 275. So in the next test case, suppose you are taking 6, the output would be 6, 12, up to 60. And the final output or the sum of these things will be 330. So first of all, we need to display this series, and second thing is the sum of the total, or you can say total of these things you need to print. Two print statements should be there. So if you see carefully, first of all, you need to run a for loop up to this thing, and we need to simultaneously you need to print these things by simply multiplying with the I, or you can say the increment thing. So here you can see we are taking I n. So here we are taking n, I value equal to 0, or you can say the multiplication table, and some final sum or the result equal to 0. So we are taking the user input here, scanf, it is fine. Then for loop I equal to 1 up to 10 we are running. So plus plus I, the value equal to n into I. So here n was, suppose here n equal to 10. So for the first time I equal to 1. So first it will print 10, and it will first print 10, then sum equal to sum plus value. Previously or initially sum equal to 0, so it will print 10, then it will finally, it will be printing the sum. But we are inside the loop, so first it will be printing 10, then again it will print 20, then it will print and then add with the sum, then again it will print 30. So that means 4 less than equal to 10, yes. Then again 40, then it will increment 4 to 5, then 5, 50, then 60. Like this, it will be printing up to 100. That means I equal to 10. I less than equal to 10, yes, it is true. Then it will be printing 10. So if you add 10 up to 100, you will be getting the output. Finally, we need to print the sum. So remember one thing, you must not be printing this statement or the value of sum inside this for loop, otherwise it will simultaneously be printing the value of the sum as well. With this 10, you will be getting the 10, then for the second case it will be getting 30, and then 10 30 plus 30, it will be giving you the 70, and like this you will be getting, the output. If you print this print statement inside the for loop, you need to print the value of sum, or you can say the value of total of these things at the end of this for loop, or you can say end of the execution of this multiplication table. So you must be printing this thing outside the table. I have seen that most of the candidates or the most of the people commit this mistake by simply putting this inside the for loop or inside the condition statement. You must be printing this thing outside the for loop or outside the another loop. If you are using the while loop, for that case also you must be there outside the for loop. So this is all about this. So it's an easy question, but most of the time the candidates, those who are not good at the coding, they commit the mistake. So if you want to become an IT engineer or software developer, you must be ignoring this thing. So check the syntax error or the logical error to correct the error to get the desired output. Given n, print n equal n to 0. So here again we have given you hint here. So unsigned integer I equal to 0, it's a easy question, but here they have used unsigned. So you must be knowing what is the use of unsigned and what is unsigned integer. Signed integer and unsigned integer, what are the concept or the what is the logic behind the unsigned integer, you must be knowing. So that's why they have given. So here if you see unsigned integer I equal to 0, everything is fine. Here if you see carefully, the code is written fully fine except, or will run fully fine except this line. Here is the error. So unsigned integer I equal to n. So if you know or not, I don't know, but the range of the unsigned integer is from 0 to 6. So the range of the unsigned integer is 0 to 65535 up to 65535. So this is the range of the unsigned integer. So if you are putting this, it will simply give you a infinite loop, and it will be giving you a error. Cyclic way, it will be going on like this, and you'll be getting a compilation error. So now let's move to the 10th question. So here we have not giving you any hint here. So you need to find the output by yourself. So find the logical error in the following code. So this is a factorial question. So it's one of the, you can say, most favorite question of each interviewer as well as the each candidate. So if you see carefully, we have taken long integer factorial 1, we have initialized the value or the factorial value, then n, then I. So we are taking the value of n here, user input. So we have taken the long integer. So if you see carefully, the error there in two places, the errors are there. So you need to find by yourself. So the error one is here and the second error is here. So try to rectify, or you can say try to check why it is coming, or how we'll be getting the error. So here if you see carefully, we have declared long integer fact equal to 1. So while taking the input, you must be, first of all, it must be LD, means small LD. It must be small LD, not the capital ND. It must be small LD, or you can remove long here, long from here, and put D if you want to assign it as D, or every integer. If you want to assign everything as integer, you can assign by simply putting integer here, and inside this scan statement you can simply print percentile D if you want. If you are taking long integer, the small ld must be there, not like alphabetical order, or you must be knowing, must be not be ld here. So in the second error, here you can see integer is there. Either way you can do this. If you are keeping long integer here, so you need to simply change ld here and the small ld must be there. Otherwise you can simply remove long integer here and put integer only. So this is all about this question. So silly questions they will be giving, because they know the candidates, those who have less programming practice or the coding practice, they will stuck here or commit mistakes. So now let's move to the 11th question. Find the logical error in the below code. So integer a, b, c, everything is there. We are simply doing the adding statement here. So if you here, we want to print the value of c here, but where is the error? You must be thinking that it's correct. Where is the error, or is there any error or not? You might be thinking. But if you see carefully, here is the error we are getting. So to the left side of plus, there are two operands here, but it must be one only. It will be throwing the error in this line only. If you want to try it by yourself, you can type this code in your compiler. It will definitely throw this error that two operands are there, left side to the left side of equal to sign. So let me remove this. So if you see the explanation, we have used the statement a plus b equal to c, which is incorrect, as we cannot use the two operands to the left side of the equal to. So if you want to rectify this, you need to simply put c equal to a plus b to the left side of a plus b. We need to put c. So here you can see, if you type this code and compile this, definitely you will be getting the output. So now let's move to the 12th question. So find the error again, logical error here. From the logical error in the below code, integer main a, b, c. So if you see carefully, definitely I bet 90% candidates will fail to answer this question. So you might be thinking that everything is correct here. Integer main, integer a, b, c, a equal to 10, b equal to 30, so c equal to a plus plus, plus minus minus b, and b minus minus. So you need to most of the candidates will start calculating this. From this thing only they will start the execution. The candidates will might be thinking, yeah, a plus plus equal to 10, then plus plus will take you 11, then it will be having 11, then again they will move to this, it will be taking minus minus, that means 29. People will start calculating and will then they will be simply wasting their time here. But whenever there is a, here I am giving you a tips that whenever you are here, you see, whenever you are getting this type of question or find the logical error, try to check each and every line carefully, because they know the candidates, those who have less coding practice, definitely they will stuck here. So that they want to know whether you know the correct syntax or not, if you are comfortable, or you can say if you are familiar with all these things or not. They want to check whether you know the logics or whether you know the syntax, etc. So if you see carefully, in the first line the error is main. Here you can see it should be like this. Everything should be in small letter only. So if you see carefully, it is in the capital letter. It must not be there. So it will throwing an error or exception, you can say. So the exception would be the that it is getting the linker error. Most common linker error is writing main. Most of the candidates do this. They forget actually whether it is small capital or small m or capital M, etc. Like this they will stuck. Definitely there was a time when I was also used to be stuck in all these things. So please practice all these things before attending the off campus. These questions are also applicable for entity data as well as the Cognizant as well, or you can say for the Mindtree as well, because these companies follow the MCAT pattern. So that's why I am saying It is also applicable for mind tree as well as for the anterior data as well as for the cognizant. So this is all about these questions. So we have discussed here 12 questions. So out of 7 questions you will be getting, and I am sure that you will be getting 7 to 8 questions minimum from these questions only. So I hope you get a clear idea. If you are facing any doubts or if you have any difficulties, then you can comment your doubts in the comment section below. So that will be able to help you as soon as possible. So thank you for watching and all the best for your job search.